Hello everyone, I am Sara El Hamdani, a postdoctoral researcher in the Faculty of Sciences, Czech Technical University in Prague. It is a pleasure for me to participate in the third edition of IEEE Middle East and North Africa Communications Conference to present our paper entitled A Markov Decision Process Model for a Reinforcement Learning-Based Autonomous Pedestrian Crossing Protocol, co-authored by Sara El-Hamdani, Salah Kinnudari, Stanislav Novotny, Peter Bushner, Nabil, and Nabil Bonamar. So the reminder of my presentation is the following. I will start with a quick introduction to the problem, to the problematic. Then I will give an overview of the autonomous pedestrian crossing protocol and of the Markov decision process. In the third section, I will present our proposed model, including state space, the action set, and the reward functions of our MDP. And I will finally finish with the discussion and the conclusion. So, developing distributed traffic management architecture for a future without traffic lights based on autonomous vehicles capabilities and artificial intelligence techniques is a current trend in ITS research area. Deep reinforcement learning is one of the closest artificial intelligence models to human learning and the most successful one for driving process. Therefore, a Markov decision process is needs to be defined in order to allow reinforcement learning based systems to process a sequential decision making. In this context, the problematic of our paper is focused mainly on autonomous pedestrian crossing protocol, which is a promising solution for pedestrian integration in autonomous traffic management systems in terms of minimizing traffic delay and congestion rate. However, the main limitation of this protocol is that it is based on static programming instructions, which does not enable the autonomous vehicle to learn from the past experiences. So the purpose of our paper is to define an MDP framework that forces the autonomous vehicle to behave respecting to autonomous pedestrian crossing protocol. We'll see now an overview of autonomous pedestrian crossing protocol and the Markov decision process. So autonomous pedestrian crossing protocol consider the road and the crossing lane and crossing lane by lane, and consists on inserting refuge islands between the lanes that both pedestrians and vehicles can consider one part of the crossing, which is the crossing lane. And APC undertakes also a safety zone to protect pedestrians in case of an emergency break-in. So, for example, in this scenario, the red vehicle is concerned only with the safety, with the collision region, which is the safety zone of direction one, lane two, or D1SZ2, plus the crossing part D1 CL2. accordingly, an approach in vehicle will sense this particular area by reading input from its front camera, or it will analyze the received cooperative awareness message in case it is occluded by another vehicle, and it will in this case optimize its decision in order to minimize the traveling delay. Markov decision process consists on a state space S, an action space A, a transition probability model P, and a reward function R that which are the inputs of an MDP, and for its process it's consider a discounter factor lambda, and it aims to maximize the expected sum of discounted rewards according to the value function V. And thus to compute the optimal policy P star. We'll now move to our proposed MDP for reinforcement learning based autonomous pedestrian crossing, autonomous pedestrian protocol. So generally, the agents that that can apply this framework can be the front autonomous vehicle VI or the next coming vehicle VI plus one. Respectively, the autonomous vehicle will observe the state ST of its environment, which is the collision region, at time t. According to autonomous pedestrian crossing, it will sense this region either by sensing directly using the front camera or through analyzing the received cooperative awareness messages received from VI or from the front vehicle. And consequently, based on the state ST, the agent will select an instant driving decision, AT plus one, that will minimize the travel delay according to APC protocol, and thus it will maximize the reward RT plus one. So we have, as a state space, we have first defined the collision region state based on the input of the front camera and based on the considered cooperative awareness message that includes, this state space includes seven states. So for S1 and S2, they concern the front vehicle, and they refer respectively to full collision region or to free collision region sensed by front camera. And in this case, there is no considered cooperative awareness messages. For states from S3 to S6, they refer to states where the vehicle can't rely on the front camera and considers the front vehicle VI minus one action. For the last state seven, it concerns the case where the front vehicle is too far, and in this case, its action is not important for the vehicle VI. The action sets according to APC protocol includes four possible actions. The first one is to stop, And it is the less optimal action that can be taken in the worst cases. And A2, which is decelerate, is more optimal than A1 and supposed to be taken in not sure states, such if the vehicle is too far and if the front vehicle is slowing down. A3 or action 3, which is keep going, and it's more optimal compared to A1 and to A2, and it means continuing with the same velocity. And the most optimal action, A4, which is accelerate, and it helps to save and maximize the allowed speed. So the reward functions we have set to our model are 4 reward functions for each action. And for the possible actions are rated from the less optimal A1 to the most desired one, A4, as we have aforementioned in the previous slide. So for this preference rank, we add respectively -5, -1, +0, and +1 points to each function. And the velocity also is expressed logarithmically in the actions involving movement. This is a graphical representation. This is a graphical representation of the 4 reward functions in increased velocity. And you can observe the difference between the 4 functions. Finally, we have arrived to the discussion and conclusion. So in our paper, we have developed an MDP model that enables autonomous vehicles to read and understand the crossing situation and to think dynamically and choose the optimal driving decision in order to minimize traffic delay and crossing the crossing area. And we have also defined the state space, the action set, and the reward functions for this model in order to force the autonomous vehicle to act according to APC protocol, logic, and objectives. So the use of our model for reinforcement learning based version of the APC protocol will allow the autonomous vehicle to actively learn how to optimize its decision through experiences and to be able to enhance its performance gradually and outperform the traditional programming based APC protocol. Thanks for watching.